Hello everyone. Today we would be discussing three other bacteria that are Chlamydia, Mycoplasma and Legionella. And all of them are responsible for causing atypical pneumonia. We would start with Chlamydia. Now Chlamydia, they have got certain characteristics like they are all obligate intracellular bacteria. Also, they cannot be grown in artificial media. They do require certain cell lines for their growth. Chlamydia, they are quite small enough to pass through bacterial filters. That is why they are filtrable. And also, they produce intracytoplasmic inclusion. Because of these characteristics, they were once thought as viruses. But now Chlamydia are now confirmed to be bacteria because they do have some properties which are similar to that of bacteria. We would be discussing two organisms of this family. The first is Chlamydia trachomatis and the second is Chlamydophila pneumoniae. Now Chlamydia trachomatis is primarily a human pathogen causing ocular, urogenital and neonatal infections. Based on the antigenic structure of Chlamydia trachomatis, there are 19 serovars which have been identified which are affecting humans. Now the serovars A, B, BA and C are known to cause trachoma. Trachoma is chronic keratoconjunctivitis, which is transmitted through direct contact with discharges from the eyes of infected patients, as we can see in this picture. The serovars from D to K are known to cause ophthalmia neonatorum, as shown in the picture here, and certain genital infections like non-gonococcal urethritis and epididymitis. Now Chlamydia trachomatis is also known to cause one of the sexually transmitted infection, that is lymphogranuloma venereum, which is caused by the serovars L1, L2, L2A and L3. Lymphogranuloma venereum is an invasive systemic sexually transmitted infection. There are three stages in lymphogranuloma venereum. In the first stage, a painless papule ulcer or vesicle develops on the penis or vulva after an incubation period of 3 days to 6 weeks. In the second stage, inguinal lymph nodes in the groin become enlarged, tender and soft, as shown in the figure here, which is also called as bubo. And in the third stage, eschewmin formation occurs, which is an edematous granulomaceous hypertrophy on vulva, scrotum or penis. Also, elephantiasis of the vulva or scrotum may occur. The next organism is Chlamydophila pneumoniae, which is known to cause atypical pneumonia, which we will deal later in detail. Atherosclerosis, asthma and COPD. Coming on to the next one, that is Mycoplasma. Mycoplasma are very small in size, their size being approximately 150 to 350 nanometer, and they are also filtrable by bacterial filters. Because of these two properties, they also resemble viruses. But because they can also grow on artificial cell-free culture media, they are considered to be bacteria. One of the very important characteristic of Mycoplasma is it lacks a rigid cell wall. This organism doesn't have a rigid cell wall. Instead, it is replaced by a cell membrane containing sterol, as we can see here. Because it lacks the rigid cell wall and it only has a cell membrane that contains sterol, it doesn't take up the dye under Gram staining. and hence it cannot be visualized with light microscopy. Also, as it doesn't have rigid cell wall, the antibiotics that works on the cell wall are completely resistant, and hence mycoplasma are completely resistant to beta-lactams. One of the important species of mycoplasma is Mycoplasma pneumoniae, which is the causative agent of primary atypical pneumonia. This Mycoplasma pneumoniae is transmitted by respiratory droplets expected during coughing. And this transmission is favored by close contacts, as in military bases, boarding schools, and summer camps. Now, clinical manifestation of Mycoplasma pneumoniae are upper respiratory tract infection, which could manifest as pharyngitis or tracheobronchitis, pneumonia, which we will deal in the next slide, and some extra pulmonary manifestations like meningoencephalitis, skin rashes, and reactive arthritis. Now let us see something regarding pneumonia. Pneumonia is basically a lower respiratory tract infection, and it refers to inflammation of the lungs by microorganisms, and it can be classified into either community acquired or hospital acquired. Community acquired, in which the patients acquire the organisms in the community, and hospital acquired, in which the patients acquire the organisms in the hospital setting. Now, based on the clinical manifestation and based on the area of the lungs involved, pneumonia can be grouped into lobar pneumonia and atypical pneumonia. To understand this, let us have a look over the structure of the respiratory system. These are the bronchioles, the smallest airways, ending up in air sacs that is called as alveoli, which is surrounded by blood vessels. The magnified image of this section is shown here, and here we can understand this is the alveoli, the inside part of alveoli. Here are the blood vessel, and the space in between is called as interstitium or interstitial space. When the microorganism is affecting the air sacs or alveoli, then it is referred to as lobar pneumonia. And when the microorganisms are infecting interstitial space, it is referred to as atypical pneumonia. The symptoms of pneumonia involve fever, chills, chest pain, and cough. All of the symptoms are more or less same in both the types of pneumonia, but cough is the symptom which differentiates between lobar and atypical pneumonia. If the cough is productive cough with purulent sputum, then it is lobar pneumonia. And if the cough is non-productive and dry, then it is atypical pneumonia. Also, this pneumonia is called as eaten agent pneumonia or walking pneumonia, because Mycoplasma pneumoniae was first isolated by Monroe et al. Here is the list of the causative agents of atypical pneumonia. As we have already seen, Mycoplasma pneumoniae, Chlamydophila pneumonia, Legionella pneumophila, and the other agents of viral pneumonia. Now, laboratory diagnosis of Mycoplasma. For lab diagnosis, the samples that could be collected are throat swabs, nasopharyngeal aspirates, and bronchoalveolar lavage. Culture of the sample could be done on Eaton's agar media, which is rich in cholesterol and nucleic acid. After a period of 2 to 3 weeks, The colonies that would be grown on the media would be dome shaped and would be embedded on the agar surface and consist of a central opaque granular area of growth which is surrounded by a flat translucent peripheral growth, which is often described as fried egg appearance. Serology is available for mycoplasma. Antigen detection could be done by ELISA, and there are two non-specific tests for antibody detection, which are cold agglutination test and Streptococcus MG test, which works on the principle of cross-reactivity. Molecular methods available are PCR. The third organism is Legionella, which we have already discussed in the previous lecture. They are gram-negative, pleomorphic and fastidious. Legionella was first recognized in 1976 when an outbreak of pneumonia took place at Philadelphia Hotel during an American Legion convention. The two clinical syndromes associated with the species Legionella pneumophila are Legionnaires' disease, which is atypical pneumonia, and Pontiac fever, that is basically a flu-like syndrome. Just a mnemonic to remember the causative agents of atypical pneumonia. My clumsy leg video has gone all viral. Mycoplasma, Chlamydia, Legionella and viral agents. Thank you.